Welcome back to Battery Bulletin. Today I am going to talk about something that nobody haven't discussed, but one of the most important announcements from Tesla Battery Day, cell formation. Let's briefly discuss what is cell formation and why it is important. Let's break down cell production into four sections. Step 1. Electrode production. In this stage, we make the electrode slurry, coat them on current collectors, and then we dry them. Step 2. Jelly roll construction. We press and cut the electrodes, weld the tabs, and then wind the electrodes and separators together. Step 3. Cell assembly. We fill the cells with electrolyte and then we seal them. Step 4. End of line conditioning, where we do cell formation, aging and grading the cells. What is cell formation? In lithium ion batteries, during the first charge, it forms a protective layer on the electrode, which is known as solid electrolyte interface or SEI. This process is known as cell formation. The SEI prevents further degradation of the electrolyte and the electrodes. SEI is permeable for ions but not for electrons. Establishing a stable SEI is really important as this governs the cycle life and the performance of the battery cell. Similar to electrode recipe, electrolyte formula, the formation procedure is also a trade secret that battery manufacturers keep to themselves. Cell formation depends pretty much on all the parameters such as wettability of the electrodes, electrolyte recipe, cell chemistry, temperature, applied current density, etc. This is how a basic charge profile looks like for the first formation cycle. We apply a constant current up to a predefined state of charge or voltage, and then we switch to constant voltage where the current decays exponentially. Once it reaches the limiting current, we stop charging. This testing might be done at different temperatures to improve the wetting of the electrodes, along with sophisticated charging algorithms and multiple steps. This makes formation more complicated. These are a few common charging protocols that we use to cycle batteries. Some are constant current, constant voltage, step charge and pulse charge. Here are some examples for formation cycling voltage profiles for NMC graphite cells. As you can see, the voltage profile and the time required is different in each case due to different combination of charging protocols and current densities. After cell formation, these cells are moved to aging towers. During calendar aging, we don't apply any current. We monitor the open circuit voltage of the cells. This type of aging depends on the temperature and the state of charge of the cells. This is an example from an aging study which shows the relationship between state of charge or temperature with storage time. The aging process first takes at ambient temperature and then at higher temperatures between 30 to 50 degrees Celsius. The higher temperature is to make sure the SEI is stable at elevated temperatures and to identify if any acceleration in parasitic reactions. A good SEI will have a really low leakage current, whereas an unstable SEI will continue to react and cause parasitic reactions. Depending on the leakage current and additional test, these cells will be grouped. We call this process binning. Each group consists of cells that will perform similar to each other, and this ensures less complications in use application. So why should we optimize formation and aging? Formation can take between 24 hours to 1 week, whereas aging could take up to 2 weeks, making this the longest and the slowest process in cell production. Formation not only takes more floor space, but uses expensive, precise charging electronics, environmental chambers, which means a huge capital and operational cost. Let's have a look why Tesla obviously have to improve formation. High speed continuous motion assembly. According to this slide, it could yield 7 times more output. All these cells need to go through cell formation and aging, and it could normally take roughly 3 weeks. Now you can see it doesn't matter how fast that you produce these cells. Unless you invest more capital to buy formation equipment, this will always be a bottleneck. The output of battery packs depends on how efficient is the slowest step of the manufacturing process, which is cell formation and aging. Instead of investing more money, they announced they were able to cut down the formation investment by 86% and the formation footprint by 75%. This is a huge achievement. So how did they improve formation? In terms of power electronics, they revealed that they were able to use parallel charging. I don't know much about power electronics, but from what I found from a company which provides power electronics for formation, they mentioned that these electronics should be highly efficient, at least above 90%. One of the other things that they mention is recycling energy. During discharging a cell, instead of using a load and dump that energy as heat, you can direct that energy to a cell that needs to be charged. This way, you need only less amount of extra energy to charge the cell. Power electronics alone cannot take the heavy lifting to reduce the footprint and cost. There has to be improvements in formation protocol as well. I think they might have found ways to reduce the formation below 24 hours. This could be something similar to supercharging, where it generates heat and improves kinetics to avoid lithium plating. They might be using high current pulses and reduce the formation time. What about aging time? I took a hint from their presentation. They mentioned that they have learned from cycling billions of cells. To me personally, this means they have an incredible pool of information about these cells. Using big data analysis and artificial intelligence, they might have already found ways to spot the minute differences of perfect and near-perfect cells within a few days, not weeks. We always hear about cathodes, anodes improvement in media, and I wanted to show that formation deserves to get the same attention as well. If you have experience with formation and electronics, please comment. I would like to learn more about them. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please give us a thumbs up. And if you are interested in battery videos, subscribe to my channel. If you like to support this channel, check out the Patreon in description. Stay safe and see you soon on Battery Bulletin.